Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? High overhead, not long after it gets dark, note the cross shape of Cygnus, running from Deneb towards the northeast to the spot in the southwest of the constellation between the other two summer triangle stars of Vega and Altair. This is where Albireo forms the beak of the swan. Between these two stars of Cygnus are Sodder, the 2.2 magnitude star at the intersection of the cross, and 3.8 magnitude Eta Cygni, not quite halfway between Sodder and Albireo. This is our starting point for this week, so if you can't quite see this star naked eye, use binoculars or magnified finder and aim just slightly towards the Sodder direction of halfway between the two stars. We're going to go from Eta Cygni in the direction of, there's not much that's bright and nearby in the direction we're going. With some magnification, though, and centering Eta, you'll see this grouping of three stars, just slightly off the Sodder-Albireo line, in the direction of Sodder. Of this triangle, that consists of 27, 28, and 29 Cygni, go to the closest one here. That's 27 Cygni, and it's an interesting star, being a K spectral class subgiant. That is also an RS Canum Venaticorum type variable star. These types of stars are very close binary systems that have active stars spots, which can be quite large. These spots are very likely the cause of the variations seen in luminosity. Stay right there for a really interesting open cluster. And now this week's dark sky fact. Unshielded or poorly aimed light at night can cause light trespass, a situation where a fixture illuminates an area outside of its intended target. Check your own lights to be sure that when they're turned on, they only light up your property. If they don't, re-aim or shield the light, or better yet, replace it with a dark sky approved fixture instead. Center 27 Cygni with an eyepiece showing a full 1 degree of sky. Open cluster 6871 is in the field of view. Now move very slightly towards the south, placing 27 towards the northern edge of the field. There are under a dozen stars from 7th to 9th magnitude, most forming a bit of an arc shape. To me, it looks kind of like a compound bow. The arrow is right there too. There's also a couple of double stars, and at least one of them is really unique. Up here in this section of the cluster is a group of three stars. There's a double here that may not be initially apparent at a wider look. With higher magnification, you can see a 7th and 9th magnitude double star. The secondary takes a bit of careful observing to see well, though. But the separation is a not too difficult 11 arc seconds, and we'll return here in a moment. Nearby and down the curved arc or bow of the cluster is this pair, much wider at 21 arc seconds of angular distance from another. Most of the stars in NGC 6871 are very young, B spectral class hot stars. But the brightest one at the end of the arc or bow that also appears to form a double is an O class star. The cluster itself is quite young, only about 5 million years of age, and is over 5,000 light years away from us. So light from these stars left this cluster towards Earth during the early Bronze Age, around the time of the first construction that Stonehenge was being completed. But about that one star, this brightest 7th magnitude one, that's called a Wolf-Rayet star. These are really unique in that they are very hot and losing mass rapidly as their stellar winds push material from the stars outward in a shell of fast-moving gas. These stars are very short-lived, so there aren't many of them in the sky to even study. This star is also known as WR-133 for Wolf-Rayet number 133. More information about these interesting stars at eyesonthesky.com. If you like this video, please subscribe on YouTube or like Eyes on the Sky on Facebook. And be sure to visit eyesonthesky.com too. There's a lot more about amateur astronomy there. Thanks for watching. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.